Okay, so we're gonna go back and we're gonna look at this shape that we've kind of developed into an architectural unit and then repeated that unit to turn it into a module, and now we're gonna talk about developing that into a plan. We're gonna talk about stairs in the next tutorial, so right now I'm really just gonna focus on walls and apertures. You only have one entry in this plan for the purposes of this class. All the other openings should be apertures, otherwise known as windows. Thicknesses for walls. As we talked about in class, walls should be plus or minus 10 centimeters if you're dealing with concrete. Some concrete is thinner than that, some's thicker. It depends on the height of the building and the weight of the building and things like that. You'll learn about that later on. You shouldn't really worry about it, but for the purposes of this class, 10 centimeters more or less for concrete. 15 centimeters roughly for wood framing. That's when you have a wood frame inside of the wall and then it's sheathed on either side, interior and exterior, with other sheet material, which makes it thicker. 20 to 25 centimeters roughly for masonry units. Those are concrete blocks, otherwise known as CMUs, concrete masonry units. Okay, so I'm just gonna draw the walls. I'm gonna look at this area. You can see how we resolved this area. We made it wider so we can get a stair in there later. That's where I'm going to put the stair. And I'm gonna look at this area and this area, and I'm gonna leave that sharp edge on the exterior of the plan, and I'm going to resolve it on the interior of the plan because you probably like that sharp edge. So I'm just going to start making my walls, and I'm going to deal with that area first. You can see that the walls, because I'm cutting through them, are actually drawn with a heavier line weight. Obviously you're going to be using graphite and you're going to be hard lining this. For the purpose of these tutorials, I'm going to be using my Sharpie. Come down to about here, and then you can see I'm just gonna flatten that out so that that space potentially has some use in the interior of that building. Now, if you pay attention to me as I draw these walls, you're gonna see that I start to recognize certain alignments. And it's not necessary in this class, it's not a design studio. But it's fun to practice. It'll make your plans feel a little bit better. You can see I'm starting to make other alignments to other places in the building. You see these windows are starting to align themselves across the plan. And at some point I'm going to have to decide where I'm going to put that entry stair. We'll do that in the next tutorial. Remember, I'm going to resolve that sharp edge on the interior of the plan the same way I did on the other side. Now, you don't have to make your apertures in one unit the same as you did on the other unit. I'm just doing that for ease and speed right now, and it's not a design studio, so obviously there's no requirement for that. Obviously, if you were upstairs in a design studio, there may be reasons not to make these symmetrical. You may want to choose asymmetry. Those apertures may actually be based on program, how the space is used. Okay. Now I'm going to poche these walls in my rough way. You're obviously going to use a straight edge. They'll all be drawn at the same angle, very light lines to fill these walls. Now, technically, they could be solid fill, black, there could be a gray solid filled screen, there could be no fill, or you could have the poche diagonal hatch lines, as I've asked you to do. so that we can still see the line work in the walls in terms of the line width. So that's the plan starting to come into view. And now I'm going to decide where I want my entry to be. And as you know, this outside line is really the perimeter of the building. It is essentially the plinth of the building that has been raised up, the ground plane. That also designates where the ground is. So everything outside of that line, that light line that I drew first, is the ground. So now I'm going to determine where my threshold is, which should just be one line, and then I'm going to add an interior line for all of these apertures so that you understand there is a ledge there that is raised up above the floor. So I'll start drawing in these sills, otherwise known as little ledges, that are just above the floor at about a meter. Now I said in class 1.5 meters, but I think after thinking about that, really they should be drawn at about a meter above the floor. We'll talk about that in a future video. And so now we understand that that's the threshold, which means that there will be an exterior stair there. I have to locate my interior stair, which I will do in a future video.